way.
Up! Up!
Shoulders, Haggerty, and he sets things off with a nice teep kick to the midriff. Oh, and that was a huge-looking right hand that did not land.
Yes, Steve, that was an elbow. He was trying to close that distance and throw those bows. Expect Haggerty to throw all the different weapons. See, this is the start that I was talking about. He immediately starts to come out firing, and he's going to the body, too.
He's really going for it. He's missed so far with those huge bombs, but they are big. And there's another one. Just off target with them so far. Three massive blows, all have just hit air.
Beautiful spinning back elbow, just barely misses Mongkolpetch. This is where Mongkolpetch needs to start leveling up. He doesn't want to give away this first round. Haggerty's starting to get off, close that distance. Look at the speed at which he's attacking Mongkolpetch, closing the distance, and he switches to southpaw. He's an innovative switch hitter, expecting to change stances.
And we saw that Haggerty elbow that you spoke about a moment ago, and he followed up with a nice swinging wide arc left hand. There's the elbow coming down there as well. Haggerty looks to be like ragdolling Mongkolpetch. He's looking to really rough him up in there.
See, it's the movement of Haggerty. He's never standing still. Mongkolpetch, you can see how his feet are planted. He's waiting to tee off on Haggerty, but Haggerty's not giving him that opportunity, coming in and out, darting like a fencer, just throwing those hammers of elbows at him, though.
Remember what Mongkolpetch said, that Haggerty is weak in the body. Will he be targeting that anytime soon? Or will he wait till the later rounds where perhaps the Englishman is tiring a little bit?
Well, this is typically what Mongkolpetch does. He'll give away the first couple minutes just to get a read on you, just to understand your distance, your timing, and your rhythm. And then once he starts to get you, he'll start to level up. But he doesn't want to give away this first round like this. And he's letting Haggerty just touch him over and over again as he digs to the body right there.
This is an interesting thing, isn't it, about a time Muay Thai fighter against a non-time Muay Thai fighter. The Thais tend to start slowly, don't they? And feel out the process. Well, that's not happening here. You can't really do it, not at the pace that Haggerty started with. Light on his feet.
Ooh, nice little switch there to southpaw momentarily. You can hear the coach of Haggerty, Christian Knowles, throwing, telling him to lead with the jab. Everything is going to get opened up with that jab, and that's what he needs to do. Look at Mongkolpetch.
Oh, you saw
catching the kick and just grinning at him.
You saw the grin, right? Digs. Ooh. Oh, beautiful combination. Left foot to the body and then upstairs to the head, and he followed it up with a right hand. Just beautiful hands from the Brit. Very little effect.
Yeah, this is one thing Haggerty said that Mongkolpetch was going to do. He says he has a really good shell and he protects well, so he was going to start digging to that body whenever you start to see Mongkolpetch cover up.
Got to admire Mongkolpetch's chin at the moment, because he's taken some
keep
money.
That pace on him.
Yeah, you should see. You should see an increase in the tempo from the Thai. Oh, good work from both of them. Now it's heated up. Now it's getting ready. It's coming to boiling point now. Mongkolpetch moves forward, but takes some punishment for his efforts.
You can hear Christian Knowles saying for Haggerty to take the center, take it, because Mongkolpetch is hunting right now, stalking Haggerty down.
Great kick to the midriff there from Mongkolpetch. There was power in it. Gets that kick caught, though.
Good catch and dump. Now, dumps don't really score, but they just show dominance over somebody. If you're throwing somebody to the ground like that, you're imposing your will on them.
Yeah, emotionally, there's got to be some kind of an advantage there. Right hand from Haggerty lands high up on the forehead. These two have upped the tempo, particularly on the part of Mongkolpetch.
Dump again, dump again. Look, Mongkolpetch digging to the body right there.
Does well with it too.
Now Haggerty's on the back foot.
On his bike and is taking punishment. Mongkolpetch has turned things up. He goes downstairs, attacks that body, comes back up as well. Haggerty nods at him, saying, come on then, if that's what you've got, give me more. But can he respond in kind?
There's that up elbow trying to split the guard of Mongkolpetch, but Mongkolpetch has turned it up in this second. Going to the body over and over again, these hooks. Oh, and the big right hand landed.
The heat is on midway through the contest now. Mongkolpetch has changed gears. No question. Goes downstairs, left, right, left. Misses with the uppercut. And there's a smile on his face. Starting to enjoy it.
Dig into the body, man. Those are, he's loading up. He's torquing and loading everything into those body shots.
Haggerty is open mouth, starting to show the first signs, perhaps, of flagging a little. There's a long way to go here. 45 left in the second.
Yeah, 45 minutes is a lifetime in there with a striker like Mongkolpetch.
Still coming forward, still throwing knees and elbows, Haggerty. He favors that elbow. But a little bit of the crispness has gone, a little bit of the eagerness to land first and to land hard has gone.
Well, Mongkolpetch's not standing still anymore. He's pushing forward, so Haggerty is forced to stay on his back foot and answer from there, so he's not able to load and reset. Mongkolpetch's digging to the body, even inside the clinch with those knees.
And with Haggerty's back against the circle wall, that thrashing kind of fist and forearm combination all in one punch from Mongkolpetch. One big effort required from both men. The biggest effort, arguably, of their careers to snatch this one.
Mongkolpetch has switched to kicks, Steve. Look at him, he was going body shots with the hands in the second. Now he's going kicks to the body in the third. Now he's entering inside that clinch with the knees.
What a little elbow there. You might just have caught it. I think it might have caused, yes it has. You can see the wound there. You could see the blood on the elbow of Haggerty. It was a thrashing elbow that caught him high up on the temple. Now, what impact will that have on these final 2 minutes and 20 seconds?
That's the danger of those elbows with Haggerty, man. He swings those things around like katanas.
That's got to slow a man down. It's swelling up. It's looking messy. Wonderful dig to the body there from Haggerty. Has he got it in him to come back after a slightly disappointing second round?
Told you, Steve, that Jonathan Haggerty with those elbows is like Edward Scissorhands, man. He will cut you up.
Well, you said it, bro, and he landed right on the hairline there with that elbow, spinning as he did it. This has been a roller coaster ride, this one. And there's still plenty of time for it to take another direction. Mongkolpetch plods forward, looking for that big punch, the damaging punch. All the while, you can see that welt on his temple. The damage has been done. What can Haggerty do to make it even worse? 80 seconds left now. We talked about body language a lot tonight, Mitch, haven't we? You're seeing something just fall away, perhaps, from Mongkolpetch.
Mongkolpetch was putting everything he had into those shots, trying to get Haggerty out of there, but Haggerty still keeps that desire alive, answering right back. They're going down to the final 60, Steve.
I think the color that you're seeing in Haggerty is all come from his opponent. I don't think Haggerty is marked. I'm not betting any money on it, though.
Mongkolpetch still being aggressive, still looking for those big shots.
That was a big swinging left hand, that's for sure. But it may be all that's left for Mongkolpetch now. Big single haymaker shots.
This is Haggerty's chance. It's just, you can see Mongkolpetch slowed. He's on his back foot now. That pressure is gone from Mongkolpetch. This
inside
is Haggerty's opportunity.
The last 23 seconds now, Mitch.
Does Mongkolpetch believe he's done enough to take the round?
It's a risky proposition if that's what his thinking is.
Countering big with the right hand, eats the kick to answer with the right.
Decent right hand it was too, landed around the ear there. Spinning back elbow, landed flush on the cheekbone from Haggerty. The belly.
Jonathan Haggerty!